So this is the Hyundai Aura, and it competes with the Maruti Suzuki Dzire and Honda Amaze in the compact sedan segment. It is based on the Grand I-10 Nios, so you'll see a very familiar looking front, but what sets it apart are these double boomerang shaped DRLs, a completely new lower portion of the bumper, and subtle changes to the grille. But what's actually really different is the rear, the boot. The rear of the Hyundai Aura has been stylishly turned out, but it seems a bit overdone and draws mixed reactions. The boot can swallow 402 litres of luggage, 2 litres more than a Honda Amaze. What sets the Hyundai Aura apart from the Grand I-10 Nios is of course the rear seat. You get a drop-down armrest here with 2 cup holders and rear AC vents. Now the seat itself is raised a bit, so you get good under-thigh support, a decent amount of leg room, and adequate headroom for a 5'8" like me. Hyundai has loaded the Aura with features. You get a rear view monitor and reverse camera, an 8-inch infotainment system with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, wireless phone charging, and keyless start. The top petrol variant also gets cruise control. I'm now driving the diesel variant of the Hyundai Aura. This comes with a 1.2-liter 3-cylinder EcoTorque diesel engine, which is BS6 compliant, puts out 190 Nm of torque and 75 PS of power, which is par for the course, similar to the Dzire diesel. But the thing is, come April 2020, this car is going to be one of the few diesels in this segment because Maruti is discontinuing their diesel and it's not going to have much competition. The price increase on the 1.2 diesel is only about 1,17,000 rupees compared to the petrol variant of the same specification. That's because Hyundai has managed to keep the cost down despite having added a diesel particulate filter, a lean nitrous trap, and all the other paraphernalia that's needed for a BS6 compliant diesel engine, which is why a lot of other manufacturers are getting out of the diesel segment. Fuel efficiency is a claimed 25.3 kilometers per liter for the diesel engine. Being a diesel, NVH levels are quite good in this. You don't feel the engine noise intrude in the cabin much, except when accelerating hard. That 3-cylinder thrum is there. The clutch is light, gear shifts nice and easy, and the steering, of course, typically Hyundai, light. If you've driven any of the other Hyundai cars, you know what I'm talking about. So that for you is the Hyundai Aura. It comes in 10 variants with a 1.2 litre diesel engine, a 1.2 litre petrol engine, and a 1 litre turbo petrol. You get an option of an AMT as well as 5-speed manual. Prices range between 5.8 lakhs ex-showroom for the base petrol, going up to 9.04 lakhs for the top spec diesel variant. It competes with the Honda Amaze and the Maruti Suzuki Dzire. The design may get mixed emotions, but then that's probably going to be the single deciding factor for this car. If you like this video, don't forget to share it and subscribe to the Quint.